Hello guys, Dejan here, welcome back to the channel. In today's short video I will try to explain you and show you how I painted the Senior Massacre. I want to say at the beginning of this video that this model was quite tricky for my camera to catch it in the focus. So there is like a first 3 or 4 minutes of the video that are really not in the perfect focus. Actually, I was considering not to even upload this video because of that, but at the end I decided just to put it up because I put so much time and effort into it. So I was like quite pretty sad not to upload it. So I hope you will enjoy it, and sorry one more time for the parts of the video that are not in the focus. So I started with priming my model black with 2 thin layers of the spray. And then I start blocking the red armor panels. I use a gory red in this case, and I just applied it in 2 very thin coats. The gory red will be a little darker when applied over the black, but this is completely fine because later we will go with some much brighter red on top of it, so it will come to its full potential. Then I did completely same with the medium sea gray. I painted all the armor panels that I want to be gray or off-white, and I applied 2 very thin coats with this paint. As well, I painted the grip of his shotgun with this color as well, because I want it to be a little different tone than the rest of his weapon. Next step was to paint all the leather straps and the pouches. So for this I used the chocolate brown, and I just painted like everything else before, just with the 2 very thin coats. I forget to mention that I always, when I'm painting with these colors, I put them on my wet palette and I added a drop or 2 of water to it so that it flows better. So when I go in the multiple thin coats, I got a really good coverage at the end. Then I applied a really thorough wash of a dark tone over the whole surface of the miniature. If you don't have a dark tone, you can use a non-oil. Just dilute it a little so it doesn't look that strong. And I did a separate wash with the periscopes just on the grip of the shotgun, because I want it to be a different shade than the rest of the armor and the weapon. While the wash is drying, I'm going to paint these containers. So first one, it will be the yellow one, and I will paint it with the dark sand. That's going to be my base color for my yellow that will come after it. So just go around and apply 2 very thin coats, and you don't need to be a perfect here. And then I will use a basalt gray to paint the other one. As I said, you don't really need to be a perfect with this paint job here on these containers, because we'll do some weathering there, and even if they do, they look like really bad, it will look good at the end and complete the model. For my yellow, I choose to use a deep yellow. If you don't have this paint, any like a brighter yellow, or even the yellow with a mix of orange, will do the job. And actually, you don't need to paint the containers in the same colors that I did. Just pick any 2 different colors and paint them, and they will look decent. And then I will apply the same wash as I did on the miniature on these containers as well. After wash is properly dry, I think it took it around like 25 minutes in my case, I start highlighting the model. So I pick up Evil Sun Scarlet and I start highlighting the red parts of the armor. At this stage I covered like almost 90% of the previous paint with this, but I didn't go inside any recesses or inside of any shadow areas. So it's pretty easy and straightforward job because he don't have that much of these areas. Then I used the Sunny Skin Tone and I mixed a little in my Evil Sun Scarlet just to have a little brighter color for my highlight. And then I went around these red panels and I just did the edge highlight wherever it was possible. I just traced the edges with the tip of my brush. Then I moved on highlighting the leather. I wanted these leather pouches to look like really worn, so I used the Scrag Brown and I was just using a stippling technique like by touching the edges with the tip of my brush and try to create scratches all around these leather areas. And the last big highlight that I had to do here is to highlight everything else with the white. So I went, I highlighted the areas that I painted gray and then everything that was remained black on this model. So I did the edge highlight wherever is that possible by using the side of my brush and just trying to follow all the sharp edges. I was like mostly trying to make like a 45 degree to 90 degree angle, where that was not possible. I was using tip of my brush, but I tried to trace the every sharp edge or every line between the armor, because at the end that actually gave the final look of this model and tied everything together. Now it's time to finish off with the containers. I will just pick up Eerie Yellow and just try to repaint the yellow one just to make it a little brighter because the wash make it too dark. Only thing here is I was trying not to go inside the recesses or those holes at the front. I was just trying to avoid those areas. It took me like two very thin coats until I was satisfied with the tone of the paint. And the last thing that we need to do on the model itself is to paint all the LEDs. For this I used the light sea blue and I just tried to paint all those LED lights and as well his eyes in the helmet. And then I just pick up the pure white and put one a little dot in the middle. In the case of the eyes I put one little white line. Now we need to create some weathering effects on these containers. So I pick up Rhinox Hide and one of my very old brushes. And I just, because the tip of the brush was really damaged, you can actually just put the brush on the surface and just drag it and it will create scratches. You can use even the sponge in this case and try to dab a little paint and it will look like a scratch. And then I use Nikilac Oxide, which is a Gang's Workshop like a technical paint to create some rust. This is like a really watery, like almost wash consistency paint. So I just fill up those holes and just drag it in the areas where like the rust will collect. And that's it guys, that will be a finish of this video. I have to apologize one more time for the parts of the video that are not not in the focus, but I hope the video was okay in the end. And I would like to ask you, if you didn't subscribe until now, please subscribe to the channel. It will help me a lot and it will help this channel grow. And if you have any comments and suggestions, please leave them in the section down below and I will try to do my best. This will be all for now, guys. Stay safe, take care, and see you soon. Bye bye.